Good point.
The first one, I will show you where is Greece. So this is European map, and this is our Greece, and this is their flag with blue and white, and the cross like Sweden or Denmark in Europe. Bulgaria, the Macedonia Republic, and Albania. And in the south is the
Mediterranean.
Yes, Mediterranean Sea. And the population of Greece is up to 11 million and 300,000 people, and the area is about 131,000 square kilometer. The capital is Athens. Next is about the history. The history of Greece, about with five part is prehistory, ancient Greece, Byzantine Empire, Ottoman Empire. From Turkey and nowadays Greece.
Good.
First is in the Bronze Age we have two largest civilizations in Minoan in Greece, and Mycenae in Peloponnese. The ancient Greece is in the 8th century BC. The Byzantine Empire is in the 3rd century to 1453.
Yes.
The Ottoman Empire from Turkey is with the government is Islam. And nowadays Greece is independent on 25 March 1821. About the culture. First is about the languages. The official language in Greece is Greek. And this is the Greek alphabet. This is based on the 22 Phoenician letters. And it's thanks to this alphabet that the Roman borrowed and create the Latin alphabet which we use nowadays. Next one is about the religion. About 97% of Greek citizens follow the Eastern Orthodox. We call it Jin Tong Giao.
Good. Eastern Orthodox.
The next one is Islam, with about 400,000. To 415,000
people.
Some other religion is Catholicism, Protestantism, and Judaism. This is Athena. It's not a religion. It's not a religion in Greece, but. Is very popular and worshipped in a lot of temples in Greece.
Temples.
Temples in Greek and more than just because she is a protector of Athens, the capital of Greece.
Good.
Now we're gonna move to Greek cuisine. So Greek cuisine is influenced by Italy and France, and also is the Turkey. So in Greece, people often start their meal with a Greek salad and some main ingredients like tomato, oregano, onion, or sweet pepper, and cheese, and cucumber, and the most important is olive oil.
Mm-hmm.
This is a very famous Greece, like, it's called horiatiki salad, which is made from tomato, cucumber, shallot, onion, and their sauces, which is made from red pepper, oregano, and olive oil. And this side is the feta cheese, a very, very famous cheese of
Greece.
And only Greece made it.
Oh, and then continue, please.
The next one is, you can call it like a symbol cuisine of Greece, and that you have to eat when you go to there. If you don't eat them, like, you never go to Greece. And it's called souvlaki.
Okay.
It's a kind of grilled meat. Often it's pork, and we use with tomato, onion, and some people often use it with tzatziki sauce and pita sandwich. It's a Greek sandwich. And when you use with pita sandwich, we call it a gyros pita. But in US or UK, we call it a gyros.
Gyros pita.
But in Greek, it's G.
And
the next one is local maize. It's a Greek honey donut. And it looks like a bánh kem in Vietnam. But we don't use honey, but we use sugar. But Greek people use honey in
Greece. Oh.
This is cheese, and this is pizza cheese. And was made only by Greek people. And look like a tofu in Eastern country. And people in Greece believe that Aristeas, a son of Apollo, the god of sun and light, that thanks for their worship to the god in the Olympus. So tell his son to give cheese like a present to Greek people. So there's a lot of famous cheese like pita, kasseri, black sauce, and even so on. Next one is wine. And wine is often used in Greek meal. And this is the god of wine, Dionysus. And they believe that whenever they drink wine, they will pray and thanks for the Dionysus, this god. And the last one is yogurt. And Greek people also use yogurt like a dessert after their meal. The next one is architecture of ancient Greece.
I would like to show you an ancient Greek architecture. Greek is best known from its temple. Many Greek are found throughout the regions, mostly at Rome, but mainly the temple in Athens. There are three types of columns used in ancient Greek architecture: it's Doric, Ionic, and Corinthian. About Doric columns, the Doric was one of the three orders of ancient Greek and later Roman architecture. The Doric is most easily to recognize by its symbol, capital at the top of the columns. Next one is the Ionic columns. The Ionic column is always more slender than the Doric. Therefore, it always had a base Ionic columns. The 8 and 9 columns didn't make the tall.
Diameters.
Tall. And even more, the antebellum colonnades of late American Greek revival plantation house. Ionic columns are most often blue. And the last one is Corinthian columns. Here's the picture of in 3D models. The Corinthian order is the last developed of the three principal classical order of ancient Greek and Roman architecture. Its architectural style is characterized by slender fluted columns and allegorical capital decorated with acorn leaves and flowers. I will show you some temple art on the Indian. Athena is a god of war, wisdom, and crafts. So, she is the protector of the Greek capital, Athens. Temple of Athena
Nike.
Of the Ambrosius Athens. It has built around in 420 before Christmas. As there's more information about this temple. It's around 8 meters and long by 5 meters wide and 7 meters. The total height was a modest 7 meters. And next is Temple of Poseidon. Has no god of the sea, horse, and earth wings. The Poseidon Temple is located on the spot rocky top overlooking the Aegean Sea. Sonian Pay. And there are 15 Doric columns, and one of the 15 columns has a bowen by the British poet Lord Byron, adding to the romance of the setting. And I will show you the poem. Place me on sunny roads, marvelous step, where nothing except the webs and I may hear our motion. It's located in southern Attica, Greece, and made by ancient Greek. It's like dedication Poseidon god. Had both around put in 444 BC. I would like to show you a story of the relationship of Athena and Poseidon. Once upon a time, there was a king in Attica. He is great and he very loved his country. So he was one day to find out a beautiful name to his country. So he decided to a tribe of God to be a protector of his land. So there was two gods, Athena and Poseidon, interest to participate in his offer. So Athena is a god of crafts, wisdom, while Poseidon was a god of earthquake and the god of the sea. So it's hard to choose who will be the protector. So he decided that two gods has offered gift, so that he and his people would choose. So they come on to Acropolis and present the gifts. Poseidon striking the ground with his trident and make a leg. But because he is a god of the sea, so his water turned out salty and it's not useful for the population. Next story is Athena. She planted sitting an olive tree, which produce food and olive for all people in the city. So, great crops has impressed by Athena gifts, so he chose Athena as the protector of the city. And this is the olive tree. I would like to show you a place you must visit when you are in Greece. I'm sorry. About the fashion of ancient Greeks. Clothing in ancient Greek family consists of the children, Peplo, Himation, and Clamine. ancient Greek men and women typically wore two pieces of clothing wrapped around the bottom. The undergarment, like for example, like sheep's chiton and peplos, had a cloak, imation, or clothes.
Cloak. What does it mean cloak? Cloak. What does it mean cloak? And the cloak. Outjuang. Undergarments. Underwear. Garment means clothes. Okay. That's a formal word for clothes. Garments. Okay. Next, continue.
And in some material that they use to make clothes, they call it linen or wool fabric.
Linen. Oh, wool fabric. Good.
And these three styles of women clothes, the first one is chiton and peplos and himation. Other chiton, as you can see, the chiton was a simple tunic garment of lighter linen, was worn by girls sick in all age. Women and men can both wear. About peplos. Peplos, a straight piece of cloth, was originally worn over the chiton. The top thread clothes were folded over and pinned above shoulder, leaving the cloth open down one side. As with the children, often gonna be, they would be used to fasten both at the waist.
Mm-hmm. Okay, about peplos. Is that still fashionable nowadays?
Yes.
Do some people, women, wear peplos? Do you notice? Yes, some women, even at the office, they wear peplos, okay? And they are still quite attractive to lots of people. I continue.
The next one is the himation. The himation was a simple outer garment worn over the peplo and the chiton. It's consisted of a very heavy rectangular material passing under the left arm and secured at the right shoulder.
Good.
The cloth would be twisted around the trapezius, so passed under the left arm and over the right shoulder. A more voluminous condition was worn in cold weather. As you can see, it's more longer than.
Speak loudly. Yeah, go.
The last one is chlamys. The chlamys was a seamless rectangle of woolen material worn by men for military, or hunting purpose. It was at a cloak. And fastened at the right shoulder with a root or button. The chlamys was typical Greek military attire from
5th to 5th
to the 3rd century BC.
Good.
Chanel brings and Greece to Paris.
Chanel. Yes.
Brings and she and Greece to Paris 2000.
18.
Just like you say that ancient Greek fashion has inspired a lot to nowadays, and heart like a few has inspired by an ancient Greek for Chanel.
Yes, peplos.
Yeah, this is the sign.
Chanel.
In an ancient Greek world, women like to wear more accessories, especially rich women like to use gold and silver.
Chanel.
Corobus, a chef, is the first man who won this
Okay. Corobus in the ancient Greece. So,
yes, it's the ancient Greek, because in the 7th century before Christmas,
BC, God.
They have
held another games. Yes. Okay, and again, only men were allowed to take part in the Olympics, in ancient Olympics, and they had to be naked playing the sports. Okay. Good, Santorini.
I would like to show you the Santorini, the Iceland in Greece. You guys know this place? Santorini is popular with the distinctive architecture with a typical whitewashing house and blue dormitories and paved paths.
Oh.
And the house of Santorini are characterized by structure and style. The cool cave is also called Diabolus Gatha. Mm-hmm. The church of Santorini with more than 600
churches
in
constitute. Constitute an integral. Okay. Blue and white, hold on. Okay, all of the buildings have one thing in common. White. Okay, they're all white. Besides the symbol of Greek flags, do you know why they decided to build buildings, houses in white? Now again, where is Greece located?